1967 Alfa Romeo GTA first drive. The music of a racing car is like a symphony. Ahead it is a smooth and subdued whine superimposed on a commotion, not a noise, of a shape parting streamlines fast. As it passes, the full blast of the exhaust strikes, blood vessels throb and the faint whiff of racing oil thrills the senses. Inside, it is a sensation, the echo of power rattling around the box of the body and a thrust in the back whenever the accelerator is pressed. The car that had inspired this fine prose from Autocar's Geoffrey Howard back on April 6, 1967 was the Alfa Romeo GTA, a Group 2 homologation special. This he watched practising at Silverstone ahead of the Spa 24 hours, in which the GTA would go on to take class victory over cars including the Lotus Cortina. And it's no surprise that he so admired this pretty sports coupe. The GTA was a creation of Auto Delta, Alfa Romeo's motorsport department, led by the knowing eye of Carlo Chitti, who had designed racing Alfas of the 1950s and two championship-winning Formula One cars for Ferrari. It was the hottest variant of Alfa Romeo's bewilderingly expensive Type 105 model family, being essentially a racing version of the Giulia Sprint GT, itself based on a shortened version of the everyday Giulia Saloon's Fleur Pen. Its construction was of a steel monocoque bonded to aluminium, rather than the usual steel body panels. You see, the A in the GTA's name stood for Allegorita, meaning lightened. Further weight-saving measures included smaller, magnesium alloy wheels, plexiglass rear windows, lightweight interior trim and even different door handles. In the engine bay, parts including the camshaft cover, sump, timing cover and clutch housing were made from magnesium alloy. The engine itself was the naturally aspirated 1.6-liter inline-four taken as used in the standard Giulia, but upgraded with a new dual ignition cylinder head, Weber carburetors and a Marelli distributor. His meant it could pump out around 160 bhp. Meanwhile, the cogs of the 5-speed manual gearbox were closer together, lighter, of course, and quicker shifting. As for the rest of the mechanicals, it's a fantastic recipe: rear-wheel drive, disc brakes all-round and worm and roller steering. The suspension, tuned for competition, was independent at the front with coil sprung wishbones and, at the rear, a live axle with trailing arms, coil springs and telescopic dampers. Each end had an anti-roll bar. Being a racing GTA, Auto Delta also fitted a limited slip differential, oil cooler, special exhaust, modified starter, dynamo, heavy-duty clutch, double rollover bar inside the roof, modified sports seats and bigger wheel arches to fit the wider radial tires. In a car weighing a mere 760 kilograms, all of this meant that 0-60 mph could be achieved in a fantastic 8.8 seconds, with a quarter mile coming in 16.7 seconds and top speed hitting 114 mph.